Okay, Zathucha Tavarishin, and welcome to my 18th part of Let's Play Empire Total War. And in this part, we're picking up right off after we had beaten the Italians on the beaches of Anzio, quote-unquote. And they're trying their damnedest to try and push me off the beaches and push me back into the sea. And they've come up with another force right after we defeated their initial one. So, going to be close. They outnumber them a little bit, but it says the advantage is in their favor. They have mostly line infantry and a few cannons, so I'm not really sure why it says they're in their favor. I think I got the upper hand, but I guess we'll see once the everything falls. All right, so I've created a battle line on top of this hill with my line infantry looking down from here. I think I'm in a pretty decent position to hold off the Italian attack. I'm gonna have my guerrillas move up and try and find a better position than they can hide in, and hopefully I'll be able to actually use them to come in from behind this time. Every time it seems I try and do that, I fail. But we're gonna hold this hill here and hope for the best. I think I'm gonna move these guys over a little bit. And looks like, I'm gonna move the whole line back a little bit. Back on the hill, just a tad. Anyway, I'm gonna skip ahead. So the Italians are approaching in. I'm getting shelled at by their cannons. But on a side note, how many guys have they killed with their cannons? Like one. Anyway, on a side note, I think I've actually hit the jackpot as they deployed their cannons. Whoops. I guess we're not hidden anymore. They deployed their cannons right beside where my gorillas happen to be hiding out. And that's not such a good thing for them. As I'm going to get in there and destroy these bad boys before they can do any real damage. Anyway, I'm going to skip ahead until our lines clash. Alright, so clearly Italians have reached my battle lines, but they're not in any kind of position to do anything. They keep flailing around like idiots and are getting shot to pieces by my superior troops. Also, my guerrillas have reached their cannons and are killing their troops, killing the cannons as they please. Most of them have reached my line, not really doing anything about it. These guys are losing. These guys are losing. Oh shit, they're firing at my gorillas. Run, gorillas, run! They can't hit you when they have to reload. So we're gonna, I'm gonna own this regiment right here. I'm gonna own their asses. These guys are gonna get destroyed. Some of these guys are not in a good position to fight, so I gotta reformat the lines a little bit to engage with the incoming threats. These guys are totally screwed. Once they finish reloading. Holy shit! I didn't know they had explosive shells. I best get out of that. I best speed up these guys here in taking out their artillery, so I make sure I don't get hit by exploding shells again. Because if anything's gonna wreck my day, it'll be those. But looks like we're gaining the upper hand against this regiment. This regiment is, so I've surrounded yet another regiment of Italian infantry. Whoops, you're not looking at them right now. I'm trying to chase down the one that I thought had routed. But now you're looking at them. These guys are totally surrounded and not gonna last very long. my guerrillas managed to pull a significant amount of their forces away from my main body of infantry, giving my main body of infantry a lot of time to dispatch more important targets. For example, their howitzers, which I had almost gotten, but then a bunch of fools managed to catch up to me and kill me, unfortunately. And maybe I can get these guys to finish the last of their infantry if they can ever reload in time, which I really, really hope that they do. Because that would be great. Oops, let's create an actual real line to deal with the last of these guys. Get these guys in here, surround them, and at that point we'll call it a show. Alright, they're in a line. They're getting ready to fire. Anytime. There they go. Or some of them go. So these guys thought they were like the cat's pajamas or something. I thought they could take on the whole of my army. But unfortunately for them, they are now completely surrounded from every angle. And once these guys get into a decent firing position, I'll be able to fire into their backs and hopefully finish them off. Come on, fire. Oh shit, they gotta reload. Once they reload, man, there they go. Yay, that was slightly less spectacular than I hoped. There they go, now they're routing. I guess these guys are being charged for some odd reason. I don't think the computer hardly ever charges you. Well, with that in mind, it just puts me in a good position to be able to flank them. These guys are broken, finally. Some of my guys just got hit by some shrapnel and took a bad shot. But it's all okay, all their infantry is dead and all that's left are these cannons. They're gonna be shot in the back. I will be shot in head. God, this army is just getting completely... The 2nd Spanish Expeditionary Force is a shadow of what it once was after two epic battles to maintain itself against the Italians. But in the end, they killed far more Italians than the Italians killed Spanish. Well, it's not over yet. I can say that it's pretty much over. Once these guys can actually get rid of these cannons. There they go. Yeah, the cannons were just cleared out. So these horses are completely surrounded, and they have no idea what it is that they're going to do. I killed their general, and it looks like, yeah, things are done for them. And they're going to run into some of my bayonets. Or not. Yeah, anyway, that's the end of the battle. Another heroic victory. So, this 2nd Spanish Expeditionary Force won another battle against the Italians, this time losing 366 troops at the expense of 545 Italians. But that only remains 239 troops of the Spanish Expeditionary Force, giving us a casualty ratio for that army. Jesus Christ, had about 800 troops. Man, that's a casualty ratio of like 6 to 1. I should have my calculations are right, but they might not be. But yeah, about only 1 in 6 of the initial army that landed survived. So that's pretty brutal. But anyway, this turn's pretty much done. I'm gonna have the first Spanish Expeditionary Force come up from Naples and take Rome, and that'll be it for now. Thank you guys for watching. This has been JosefVStalin, and I hope you'll join me next time when I'm sure we'll be sieging the last Italian capital at Lombardy.